On Tuesday, 28th of May, Parliament sat until about 10:30. The next morning, I started work at around 7:30 and later opened the CBIT conference. That day, I worked a 16-hour day on the back of a long week. When I voted in the chamber after 1 a.m. that evening, I was exhausted and I had flu. That was compounded by the fact I had also consumed alcohol. I made a mistake. My behaviour on that evening was wrong. I'm not proud of it, and I've rightly been admonished by the Premier. However, it also kicked off what's been the worst fortnight in my 12 and a half years of public life. A fortnight in which my actions have embarrassed the government and do not reflect the standards I've sought to uphold in public life. In relation to my trip to Canberra on Monday last week, I want to be clear that I was unwell and it was a private trip. As the Director General's report makes clear, I should not have booked the trip through the government travel contractor, and I sincerely apologise for this. In relation to my travels, some in the media have found my answers to their questions confusing and at worst misleading. I do not intend to go back over these issues, but for those who feel I've been less than accurate, I want to make it plain that was not my intention, and I'm sorry about that. Those who know me know my behaviour is out of character. This week, I've had a thorough medical review, and I've asked the Premier for leave for a month to address issues of stress and exhaustion. All of my travel, except the last Monday, which was a private trip, has been in accordance with the rules. And I spend many weekends working, as do all ministers, and I often travel, as do all ministers. Since then, there has been a range of spurious allegations against me. None of them are true, and I refute them all categorically. I am a hard-working minister, delivering some of the government's most critical reforms in housing, workers' compensation, procurement, IT, the Illawarra, superannuation, water, insurance, and I will continue to do so.